something like myself and you've got a number of bags that are like the one I just talked about here, like this bailout bag, but this is also an assault pack and whatever else. But I also got these everyday carry bags, these EDC bags that I can put different things on. Now I've got one in black, one in brown, I've got two in black actually. And you know, these are great to have around your office or your house or whatever. These should have some basic, fundamental, essential sort of items for EDC. But anyways, I've done videos about that, so check them out. What I'm talking about right now is a Karambit. So this one, if it's legal for you to carry, great. If it's not, do what I said in the last video about having illegal weapons and have it in your worst case scenario bag, maybe in your home. So like I said, if you're gonna get the fuck out and go somewhere, you're not really gonna be too concerned about the law. You're more concerned about using your tools to prolong life and protect yourself in general. That's just a very, you know, in a nutshell is what I'm gonna say. So what I've done is I've got custom made sheets for all my gear. As I've said, I've got these as well that I run concealed. But this, you know, this FGX Karambit here from Cold Steel, I really like it. I train with it, I carry it, and I've got it on a couple of my go bags actually, because I've got about six of these holsters. Now I put it here because it's nice and comfortable to get to. You know, I can put my dagger. Where is that guy? I've got this dagger here that I could also attach, this push dagger, the FGX push dagger, that I could put down here as well, because that's easy to get to. So, you know, it's all about carrying for not just for comfort but easy accessibility, but also you've got to balance that between, you know, the law and everything. Do you want to get caught? I'm not just saying is it legal or not, I'm just saying is it okay for me to walk around with this exposed like that? Is that going to get me in trouble? If not, is it going to bring too much unwanted attention? Those are considerations. But again, this is one of my go bags that's worst case scenario. My other one I carry around on a daily basis, and I've actually got, you know, when I'm carrying things out around, walking around, that's where I'd be relying on my EDC anyway. So what I'm saying is, like the other video I said before, why you should put knives on your bags, you know, on your bags and not inside your bags, it's for easy accessibility. Okay, same thing here. If I've got to grab this and run out of my house or get out of the car or whatever, I know there's one right there. So if for whatever reason, you know, I'm asleep and I wake up and I'm like, oh fuck, I've got to get this. That's the only one I can get to. I know I've got a decent tool in there, and always got folders down in there as well. So talk about that later on. But thank you for watching. If you haven't already, subscribed to this channel, and make sure you check out rawcombat.com for our online learning.